Hello everybody and welcome back to the Gamerdone channel here on YouTube. I'm Gamerdone. Today we're going to play some American Truck Simulator. So, we're back with our fresh start profile here. I believe it's episode 20 something. Oh, I'm not sure, but we got the 379 glider here. With a C16 Caterpillar with a 13 speed. This is a Featherlight NASCAR custom car hauling trailer. I did end up buying another truck. So we'll go here and look. I got the John Rudess Freightliner Cascadia. It's just plain blue truck, nothing fancy. And this is a truck we'll probably use it as our company truck. So I haven't got no Gamer Donnie Trucking logo on it or anything like that yet. I still gotta add those into the game. Yeah, we got that. And we hired another driver. Mayko G. He's a 1.7. He was one of the highest ones there's to choose from. So we thought we'd give him a try. It's $364 a delivery plus $16.82 a mile. And of course, he just hired him, so he don't have no stats or anything like that. So I'm debating on whether I want to buy a trailer or not. A trailer's probably going to be about. Let's take a look here and see real fast. And if we get one, I'm going to do that my feather night roof right here. Yeah. We're looking at. I just want a regular trailer, 80,000. Anywhere from 80,000 to 140,000. Or trailer. This is the cow haul, the cattle hauling trailer. I don't think we have any other reefer units. We got flatbeds. There ain't nothing wrong with the flatbed. That's 47,000. That's 89,931 for the low boy. Got the tanker. This should be another flatbed. Yeah. Hopper trailer. Yeah, that's what we're looking at. About 80,000 plus. Alright, while we're here, let's go ahead and check out the old cargo market. We are. Well, basically, we'll just say we're in Winnemucca. I like to find one where I don't have to drive really far to pick it up. 8 hours, Winnemucca, Austin, Nevada. We did that 26,778. Probably jump in here fire to see if I can hit the road. And fuck me right now, we're gonna have to get some fuel. I don't know if there's a fuel stop along the way. We're going to Austin. There was to be one right there. How far away is that? Miles.
Let's do this.
Where the hell is the fuel gauge on this damn truck anyway? Oh, I see it now. No, it's got eight of tank. It just has to be enough. I don't know what I can do about it.
Okay, let's find a new route.
Alrighty. With that note, we are off. This is where I gotta pick up my load, isn't it? Hold on. Let's remove this. Yeah, this is where I'm picking my load up from. So we just gotta turn around and go back.
Okay, here we go.
No big deal, we can flip around right here. I did upgrade the engine in the truck. I don't know if I mentioned it or not. We went to C16 Caterpillar. Did that little Detroit 316. I think it's like 580 horsepower. This right here is 800 horses. We'll give it a little extra power to play with. That great big ass dump truck and got little B excavators. Take you 4 years to load it. There's it is. No, that's not enough. Not that. Where the hell's the icon at? I got a clue because I sure have not. I see it. I see it now.
Finally, we are here.
That's what I'm saying. Good lord, I didn't know if I was gonna make it or not. I ain't done yet though. Okay. Maybe it's close enough. Probably not. Not like I'm backing it up to a dock, so she could be off just a little. Honestly, I forgot to change the fucking time. Damn it. Time engine makes for a shitty video. I mean, you can't see nothing. Can't see anything. I usually try to advance the time so where it's a morning time when I pick the load up. And 9.5 hours before our window of opportunity closes. 5 o'clock, so it's gonna take 3 hours to get there. 10-11 o'clock. We just have to deal with it, I guess. Wrap it up, buttercup. I'm glad we're doing the race car and NASCAR equipment out there to build the damn mine. This thing got the hell of a turbo on it. Making that boost. Only 30,800 pounds. That's what the load weighs. Another 10,000-12,000 pounds with the truck. Well, another 10,000 or 12,000 pounds with the trailer. About 14,000 to 16,000 pounds with the truck, fully loaded with fuel and everything. Hopefully we can make it there. I never changed the steering wheel on the truck. I could have swore when I was in the garage putting the lights on and everything, I changed the steering wheel, but apparently I didn't. I had it set to a nice leather wrapped chrome three spoke wheel. Oh man, speaking of wheels, I didn't activate the wheel mods with the special rims. It has a lot of low profile tires on it. Not really too big of a fan of them, but they do look good in certain trucks. I feel think we're gonna make it. I would be surprised. Desert, middle of the night, no fuel. We're in trouble. Stoplight, we're probably gonna be in trouble. Oh, we're almost there too.
Keep left and then turn left. Turn left.
Oh, we're burning fuel we don't have. .7 gallons an hour. Isn't that bad? Usually it's like a gallon an hour or so. Probably depends on what engine you got. Shit is this place? How the fuck do you get to the damn car? Who helped I do putting this thing in a corner like that? I should be slapped in the fucking nuts. We made it. $4.18 a gallon. I filled up last time, it was on like $3.38. That goes in Phoenix. Well, I like how they left the lights on the trailer. That's pretty cool. Find this new route. Let me know what you come up with. I think we're gonna go to the right, right? Right. Pay no attention to those aliens taking over the computer. Hacking into the national database. Maybe we shouldn't have turned right. Oh, now we're facing the wrong direction. Well, I'll be damned. Play Ring Around the Rosie. How the hell's the light shining on the vent too? So loud, we probably could be skipping gears and still be alright. It's like a fly on elephant's back. Well, I went with the 13 speed because 18 speed don't really need it.
And then turn right.
Unless you're going to be doing like heavy hauls or if you do a lot of mountain driving. Team speed will do job if you just if you're going for freight. It's all about the gearing. You want more pull power? Faster. Hot top speed. Damn, hit a skunk. I still got me a drink. I'm not gonna try to beat him.
Go straight on.
The last time I attempted to do that, I got ran into the side of him. They got rear-ended too. I got in the side and the back. I know you got when you merge, you got to slow down. The brain don't comprehend it, but can you pick it up a little bit, please? Right road. What we got going on up here? In the rear. Made a mod where the AI is like does heavy haul loads. I mean, there's a mod out there, I think it's by JazzCat, that will allow it you to have the regular default little boy or belly drop, whatever you want to call it, trailer. One that got a little dolly in the front, then you put a little dolly on the back too if you want it. Pretty cool though, see a car escorting down the road. Ask with care. Company's coming along pretty good. I fixed up the old Peterbilt, bought another truck, hired a driver. I'm still debating whether I'm going to buy trailers or not, I guess. They've been adding a lot of new stuff coming to America's Truck Simulator with these patches and everything. I kind of figured it would with other truck driving games starting coming out to make SES make a push them to make better things. What the fuck? Is that a deer? Somebody just smacked a deer. What's the place in Alaska? The driving simulator? I can't remember what the hell the name of it is. I played a little bit earlier and it pissed me off. So you can do 50 miles per hour, right? Anything over that, you can turn the steering wheel and keep going straight. It's just stupid. You literally can't turn unless you're doing under 50. That's dry pavement, flat. Oh, we ain't even picked the fucking load up yet. Oh yeah, we have. We're delivering now. I don't know what the hell's going on. It's a tail problem. I ain't got a clue. You don't either, and I don't. Killer Kern. I used to play a lot of American Truck Simulator with that dude. Pretty cool guy. I was watching, I found him watching one of my live streams. I was doing it on Twitch. But she looks like I throw the lights on him. That's pretty sick, isn't it? Like that. But the ones on the side are supposed to. Oh, yeah, it makes it brighter. $175, 4 hours, 56 minutes, 33.3 gallons of fuel, 26,779. Level 18. Almost 17 and a half. Alright, let's see if we get another load. Ouch, FPL. Where did I just go to? Just was that one a muck. We got a lot of choices here, don't we? 33,867. The cargo has been loaded. Alright, I want to look at something here because I don't remember what it was. Well, let's see how much. Don't crash. It's crashed. Go on, you can do it. It looks weird because of reshade. They will define fleet. Tell how much it is. $98,000 what I'll get out of it. I gotta pick another load that time.
Let's do this.
Wake up, you mother truckers. That's on the wrong key. Load for this thing's 30,000 pounds. I'm hoping we can get out this way. Button. I haven't seen no exit over there, but it says there is one. Put a sign up, let us know where the hell the exit is. My town. Piece of shit. Oh, like, where's the exit at? This is right there. Yeah, there's a road there. It's another thing about driving that time. It's just some shit.
Turn right.
Again, Casey shit. We've got one more spot open in the garage for another truck. I I'm happy with the way this truck is right at the moment. Oh, but the steering wheel, that's one thing I'd change. Track, curb banking and shit. I changed the dash light color too, but I don't think you can do that with this truck. I'm thinking some red gauges with nice purple needles, or maybe vice versa. I think purple or red gauges, purple needles would be okay. Still using CB radios. Alright, man, good old Cobra Classic. I think of what the hell is the other one? Just had it in my head. I was just thinking about it. Is that Wilson? Maybe that's what the name it is? One of the Wilson ones I like too. I don't remember what the model is too. First started, I was out with my mentor, my trainer, right? He was out for 2.5 months, something like that. He was owner operator. He had a Kenworth T2000. And, he bought me a CB radio and a refrigerator, a few things like a power inverter. Sheets for the bedding. He'd go in there and he'd play those little slot machines, the win points in the store. He'd sit in there for hour and a half playing the damn slot machines. Probably gotta go tell him, hey, I'm gonna be on the road, we ain't got time for this shit. He's a good old dude. Yeah, he wanted me to come, he wanted me to quit the company and come work with him because he was leased on through the company. So he wanted me to come and drive his truck. He said then he'll get a new truck and he'll drive that one. Me, being the dumbass that I am, declined the offer. And I wanted to do solo, so. But I do wish now, for what I know, I would have took that offer. Things would have been a lot different.
Turn right.
So technically, I'd still be working for the company. I'd just be working under him. just wanted to drive a truck. That's all I wanted. I don't care whether I had somebody with me or not. There's certain people I just don't get along with. That's why I never did the mentor. Because there's certain people I just their presence in the room pisses me off. I can't be around them. I don't know what it is, but. That probably wouldn't have been a good idea. Yeah, when I was going through the training before they changed it all, we'd run the truck like a team. He'd drive during daytime, I'd drive during nighttime. I sleep while he's driving, he's sleeping when I'm driving. I guess nowadays they just they can only drive for so many hours and a bunch of shit. I'd say the career went pretty good. Making pretty good money. I mean, I didn't have no bills or anything. Don't own a house. I got food in my belly and nicotine and coffee. And we're good to go. Bought a lot of stuff for that truck too, the company truck. I knew I wasn't going to get it back and get my money back when I bought it. Like I bought carpet for the inside, some special beds, little things like that. Back in the day, if you wanted Wi-Fi, you'd have to go to the truck stop or like McDonald's or something, use the free shit. Had to pay for the internet, there's no flying hook. Nowadays, you just take the whole fucking modem with you. Like the one I got, it's a Verizon one. You can unplug it, take it with you wherever the hell you want to go. It had a built-in battery and everything.
Keep right, and then exit right.
Oh, how the times have changed.
Exit right.
His feeder. Where the hell did that even come from? Welcome to my brain. I still say the trailer is longer than a regular trailer. Alright, I'm gonna get a burger at the burger. Hell, there's another one right across the street. You'll love our buns. Legal as hell, but we're not anyway. That's why you don't. Prime example, that's why you don't merge through an intersection. Shit, here they come. It's about running blocking for me. I'm gonna pull Smokey and the Bandit. Well, where did the entrance go? Where the fuck could it be? Skip that.
Reroute
us. 219 miles per hour, 23 minutes, 41.6 gallons of fuel, $33,867 earned. We are now 17 and a half.
Don't forget to like, subscribe, share, and leave a comment down below. We'll see you in the next video. Have a great day.